thank Fernando Mateo, some of the other local leaders of the immigrant community for inviting us out. We go a long ways back in terms of dealing with these kinds of problems. Originally North Plainfield, New Jersey, where there were roving bands of gangs who were preying on immigrants, and the police just didn't have enough resources to focus on that, particularly on the weekend nights. And most recently in Mount Kisco, where the problem really was the police. In fact, one police officer was indicted and stood trial on civil rights violations in federal court. And so just to have the presence of the guardian angels had a calming effect on the immigrant community, because I think, as you can see from the makeup of the guardian angels I brought with me today, they're bilingual, many of them are Hispanic. Many of them are going to be able to engage the immigrant community in conversation, so that if they do have information they want to bring forward, we can back channel it to the Suffolk County Police or the DA's office. And most importantly, encourage them to try to lead a normal life, not to be so terrified and afraid that there'll be other acts in which young men or young women or others decide to target them. And I think for the here and now, with it being so cold, it'll show a strong determination that there are other people who care about what's going on here in Patchouge. It's not an indictment against the community. These are problems that we're seeing not just in our tri-state area, but all over the country. And I can assure you, from the over 140 chapters we have in 12 countries, with the downturn in the economy, you're going to probably see these kinds of problems surface more and more as people definitely without jobs begin blaming one another for their situations, and then the youngsters in that community tend to go out there and start committing acts of assault and aggression against those that either they don't understand or afraid of, or they feel don't belong here. So once again, we'll be here in the evenings, we'll have a visual presence. As you can see, these are not areas where there's a lot of stores, where there's a lot of lighting. So the presence of the red beret clad, red sateen jacketed guardian angels will serve as a strong deterrent. We'll reach out to the Suffolk County Police and the DA's office, try to work hand in hand with them in adding an extra layer of patrol. And obviously with Fernando, Hispanics across America, and the other immigrant leaders of this community, to make sure that no other harm comes to anyone who should be able to freely walk the streets without having to fear that they're going to be attacked, or they're going to be stalked, or more importantly, hunted, as these young people seem to do on a regular basis for sport. Any questions?
Curtis, how much of a presence will we see? Will it be one individual at all times, or you say nights only?
Well, nights are the time when the attacks have occurred. It's also when people are most vulnerable, as opposed to daytime. Also, a lot of guardian angels are working, going to school themselves. We don't have guardian angels here in Patchouge, so we're going to have to depend on guardian angels coming in from the city, both by vehicle, and that, obviously it's great to have the direct connection to the Long Island Railroad that takes us right to the epicenter of where we need to be. But to have anywhere from 6 to 8 each and every night, divided into 2 groups of 4, or if we can get up enough vehicles, you have 2 per vehicle and radio communication and cell phone communication. That's quite an additional number of people to add to the existing Suffolk County Police that have been assigned in the area.
And this is completely voluntary?
Yeah, the Guardian Angels, it's all volunteer. As you can see, I think the benefit that we bring to the area is that most of the Guardian Angels who will be patrolling are bilingual, are Latino themselves. So you need to understand, we have Guardian Angels now in Mexico, we have Guardian Angels in Peru. A lot of the Latin American and Central American immigrants are familiar with who the Guardian Angels are.
Curtis, is there a time frame that you're going to do this through? Is it pass through the holidays? How long are you going to anticipate?
Well, clearly, you know, the holidays are of great concern, because that's when people go out and party. It's when people get very loose. A lot of the young people may decide, hey, let's go hunting. I can remember many of the situations that occurred in the city of New York that were racially charged or ethnically charged always happened around the holiday time, because people are from school, or they're back from the university, and they're hanging around, and they've been bending their elbows and drinking and partying, and they decide to go hunting. So definitely through the holidays, and hopefully we can attract maybe some young men and young women and adults out here to form a local unit to be properly trained to patrol on a regular basis.
But when we make a commitment, we're here for the long term, not the short term. And as long as the community would like us to be here, we'll certainly be here. Try to organize a local chapter that can then follow up in our footsteps and have a regular presence here for quite some time to come.
Curtis, what has the Suffolk County Police Department said about regarding immigrant goals?
Well, I haven't approached them yet. Obviously, intend on doing so after getting a tour of the area by Fernando, where the situations occurred, where the hot spots are, where we need to be in reference to being visible to the immigrant community. We'll certainly do outreach to them. I've had a good working relationship with the district attorney out here in Suffolk County and also with the county executive, so I don't really think there'll be a negative response. If there is, well,
you know, I'm used to negative responses. That certainly hasn't prevented us from organizing or having a presence in the past. I would just suggest that in this time of fiscal restraint, no one has enough police officers anywhere in this country any longer who can basically be in all places at all times. You need as many eyes and ears as is possible. I think we've proven ourselves over 30 years. The fact that we have bilingual members is an invaluable resource, I think, to law enforcement, to public safety, and to the community.
I assume they're not armed, correct?
That is correct. Guardian Angels.
So then what is their training and how is it a deterrent effect?
Well, number one, we carry no weapons. We have no special powers or privileges. But if there is a confrontation of any type, let's just say it's a normal kind of a ruckus that might occur outside of a bar, having no ethnic or racial overtones, we would just break up the dispute and send people on their way as long as no crime is committed. But if an actual crime is committed, we exercise our right to make a citizen's arrest. So we would detain the suspect, obviously call 911 like any other citizen, and wait for the arrival of the police. Now, if we do anything wrong in the process, we grab the wrong person, we use excessive force, really in 30 years, that just hasn't happened. But obviously, if a crime were to be committed, and we were in proximity to it or aware of it, we'd exercise that right to detain the suspects until the police arrive.
Curtis, a while back there was talk of bringing the Guardian Angels to Greenport. Did that happen? And is this the first?
Mayor Capel, in fact, not only joined the Guardian Angels and became the leader of the Guardian Angels, but while he was mayor there, the Guardian Angels had a presence. He's no longer mayor there, doesn't spend most of his time there. He's down in Miami. The present mayor didn't feel there was a need for Guardian Angels, so we no longer patrol it.
How did that work out in, as far as the...
Well, that was in a very concentrated area. That was in a two-square-block area that they had a severe drug-dealing problem. And in combination with the local police there, because they weren't patrolled by the Suffolk County Police, basically we were able to close down a lot of the drug-dealing operations. So it didn't have the problems that have played catch on. They have a large immigrant population in Greenport, but they really weren't having the problems that we're addressing here then. It was straight out drug dealing, drive in, drive out.
Was that the first community on Long Island, and this is the second?
First community in Suffolk County, correct. And a lot of it was, you know, people would come, drive through, buy their drugs, drive out, even come in from Shelter Island off the ferry to cop their drugs, and then to go back. Now there's very little of that taking place. Other than the drug dealing problem, they really didn't have a need for Guardian Angels.
Chris, when they see members, what do you think it's going to bring to the immigrants? Just a sense of security, of well-being?
I think the visual deterrence will make them feel better that there's someone out there in addition to the police who can protect them. Secondarily, I think on behalf of the Guardian Angels, since they can speak Spanish, we'll go up, approach them, give them literature, encourage them to be more participatory in giving information to us if they know of anything going on, which we can then give to Fernando, his organization, and to the police and to the district attorney's office. The whole idea is to encourage them to start leading normal lives.
Not to let this terrorism, this fear, so emasculate them that they're afraid to do anything, because in the back of their minds they're always wondering, is that next car going to be a wolf pack full of teenagers or others who may be stalking them or hunting them?
Thank you.
Can I just you also like people walking?
This is going to begin tonight?
Yep.
Oh, it begins tonight?
Yeah. That's 7 days a week, correct?
Yep.
Thank you.
Are you going to put some recruits out here, also locals? You're going to recruit.
That's going to be our attempt. We don't know, if in fact there will be people locally who want to get involved, but that certainly will be our attempt, so we could have a permanent presence here.